Now this is where Portal 2 gets interesting to me. I mean, yeah, it's interesting before, but now we're way down in the bottom there. We gotta climb ourselves way back up in order to have a meeting with Wheatley again. This is nearing the end of my first day of playing. Not first day of playing Portal 2 ever, you know, you can tell. But first day of recording, I guess you could say. And I'll do second day of recording, which will be to the very end. Over there are some pretty interesting things if you can... Actually, is that the right room? Maybe not. I was going to say, I thought there's some interesting things over there, but I think I'm thinking of something else. So you want to continue where it says keep out. Follow this pipe, go it over here, hit the switch, the lever. Like to replace the orange right there, put blue over there, stand in front of this, replace blue from there to here. That way I can go like that. Open up this big, huge, gigantic door, isn't it? At 300 frames per second. Pretty nice. Even while recording using Shadowplay. And when I return, I'm going to go ahead and show you the harder parts of the game. This is interesting because it's more open, you know, it's not so confined to small test, you know, rooms and test chambers and that sort of thing. You can see how open this is, and you will see this area, I think, from a different perspective a couple more times at least. I think you do. We'll find out here.
Welcome, gentlemen, to Aperture Science. Astronauts, war heroes, Olympians, you're here because we want the best. And you are it. So, who is ready to make some science?
I am.
Now, you already met one another on the limo ride over, so let me introduce myself. I'm Cave Johnson. I own the place. That eager voice you heard is the lovely Carolyn, my assistant. Rest assured, she has transferred your honorarium to the charitable organization of your choice. Isn't that right, Carolyn?
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson.
She's the backbone of this facility. Reads a postcard every day. Here are our Christmas species married. I can't personally oversee every one of them, so these pre-recorded messages will cover any questions you might have and respond to any incidents that may occur in the course of your science adventure. Your test assignment will vary depending on the manner in which you have bent the world to your will. Those of you helping us test the repulsion gel today, just follow the blue line on the floor. Those of you who volunteered to be injected with praying mantis DNA, I've got some good news and some bad news.
Bad news is we're postponing those tests indefinitely. Good news is we've got a much better test for you. Fighting an army of Mantis men. Pick up a rifle and follow the yellow line. You'll know when the test starts.
See, I think we came from there. And then here you see some vitrified doors. There's little buttons, and you can get an achievement if you listen to all of those. There's three here, there's, you know, two someplace else, and another two or three later on. So, you know, there's not too many. You gotta find them all. So here's the first three that you find. But I already got the achievement, so we move on. And they give you more backstory and some pretty good humor too, so definitely worth checking out. You can place a portal there or wait for the door to open. Either way. And what you want to do. Place the portal there. I'm going to brain fart there for a second. Head right on this pipe. Drop down.
They say great science is built on the shoulders of giants. Not here. At Aperture, we do all our science from scratch. No hand holding.
Started.
This first test involves something the lab boys call repulsion gel. You're not part of the control group, by the way. You get the gel. Last poor son of a gun got blue paint. All joking aside, that did happen. Broke every bone in his legs. Tragic, but informative. Or so I'm told. Boys just informed me that I should not have mentioned the control group. They're telling me I ought to stop making these pre-recorded messages. That gave me an idea. Make more pre-recorded messages. I pay the bills here. I can talk about the control group all damn day.
There we go. I missed that one there. Drop down. They're up down here even further.
For this next test, we put nanoparticles in the gel. In layman's terms, that's a billion little gizmos that are going to travel into your bloodstream and pump experimental genes and RNA molecules and so forth into your tumors. Now, maybe you don't have any tumors. Well, don't worry. If you sat on a folding chair in the lobby and weren't wearing lead underpants, we took care of that too.
Grab this box. I want to put it over there, so here, this way.
In case you got covered in that repulsion gel, here's some advice the lab boys gave me.
Do
not get covered in the repulsion gel. We haven't entirely nailed down what element it is yet, but I'll tell you this, it's a lively one, and it does not like the human skeleton.
Okay.
All these science spheres are made of asbestos, by the way. Keeps out the rats. Let us know if you feel a shortness of breath, a persistent dry cough, or your heart stopping. Because that's not part of the test. That's asbestos. Good news is, the lab boys say the symptoms of asbestos poisoning show a median latency of 44.6 years. So if you're 30 or older, you're laughing. Worst case scenario...
I like your style. You make up your own rules, just like me. Bean Counter said I couldn't fire a man just for being in a wheelchair. Did it anyway. Ramps are expensive.
So you want to get this area all covered in blue. Jumping from it soon enough. Good enough, right? Then I'm gonna focus on this area. Get it really good. Do it. And focus on this area. Two good splashes will do. Okay, portals have been reset. We got through that field. Let's put another one there. One right there. Over there. We're gonna use that as a launching pad. Okay, center it better. Center it better, there we go.
Just a heads up, that coffee we gave you earlier had fluorescent calcium in it, so we can track the neuronal activity in your brain. There's a slight chance the calcium could harden and vitrify your frontal lobe. Anyway, don't stress yourself thinking about it. I'm serious. Visualizing the scenario while under stress actually triggers the reaction. Now, if you're part of control group Kepler-7, we implanted a tiny microchip about the size of a postcard in your skull. Most likely you've forgotten it's even there. But if it starts vibrating and beeping during this next test, let us know. Because that means it's about to hit 500 degrees, so we're going to need to go ahead and get that out of you pretty fast.
Okay, once this area is covered good, you jump up to the switch. Make sure that it's going to come through and cover that. Once the water stops and you're through. Here.
I'm telling them, keep your pants on.
The thing
you
do is create a
portal
there.
Alright, this next test may involve trace amounts of time travel.
And then
so, create
a portal there.
If you
meet
yourself on the testing track, don't make eye contact.
Cover that wall.
Lab boys tell me that'll wipe out time. Entirely.
Now what I do is create an orange portal down here.
Do yourselves a favor and just let that handsome devil go about his business.
Easy peasy. Now I come over here. Recreate the portal for this, bouncing blue, place that over there. So it bounces over here. See? Okay. Get an orange one and bounce off that. See? Just like that.